In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to make a best-selling Redbubble design using Canva. So it's going to be a bit of a tutorial. I'm going to be giving you some tips and tricks as per usual. And I don't know if you've heard, as of recent news, clicking that like button gives you good luck. Hi guys, my name is Phil and welcome to the Money Game YouTube channel. For anyone that's new around here, I make print-on-demand content to both motivate and to give you guys tips and tricks on how to improve your print-on-demand shops. Now, if you happen to be stopping by for the first time, you've never seen my first before, I would strongly advise you to click that subscribe button with the notification bells turned on. I make plenty of videos showing you guys how to make money online for completely free. So if you don't want to miss out on that, make sure that you are subscribed. Nevertheless, for those who don't already know, I have a free print on demand starter guide that's linked down in the description. And alongside this, for anyone looking to make this more of a full-time thing, I have a paid step-by-step guide that's also linked down below. All the information is in the description. Check that out if that's something you're interested in. However, today I'll be showing you how to make best-selling Redbubble T-shirt designs using Canva. Canva is a very easy to use online software that anyone can use. They have a paid version, they have a free version, and for anyone who wants to try out the paid version, they also have a free trial for that, which will be down in the description. I will be talking about that a little bit more in a second. And just like that, a second's passed and there it is, Canva. So yeah, I've got a link down in the description, guys. If you click on that link, it'll take you to a point where you could either use the free version or you could sign up for a free trial on the pro version if you haven't used it already. As you'll go on to see, Canva is very useful. I've not yet made a tutorial on it because I was waiting for the correct time. Today is the correct time, and hopefully for those that haven't used this, after watching this video, it will give you a bit more of an insight of why you should try it out, give it a chance, and maybe even end up creating some best-selling designs yourself. So I searched far and wide on Redbubble. Well, I say far and wide, but I just jumped on Redbubble and went on kids clothing. The main reason I'm showing you guys how to design on a kids t-shirt is mainly because kids t-shirts have low competition, especially things like baby t-shirts. So if you can learn how to implement this into your own designs and actually put this on kids clothing on Redbubble, you might be able to start getting sales sooner rather than later. Or if you are getting sales already, you might be able to start to get even more consistent sales. So to find this, I pretty much went on Redbubble baby t-shirts, sorted them by best selling, and this was the third in line. I mean, you can see it there on the screenshot, but we'll just jump onto Redbubble anyway. As you guys can see here, if you go on Redbubble and you search baby t-shirts and you sort it by best selling, which you can do by changing it from most relevant to best selling, you will see at number three, we have I Still Live With My Parents. Now, any designs that show up on this top lines are designs that are doing well in terms of sales. So they're pretty much best sellers. And yeah, like I said in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to recreate something like this in your own way using Canva. Jumping onto Canva, once you have your account set up, it looks something like this. Mine says, welcome Phil. Once you're here, you want to go on create design first of all, and then once you click create design, you want to go on the custom size. Now, the largest you can do is 5,000 by 5,000. So you will type that in. I'll also be showing you how to resize and do other little useful things after your design is ready. But yes, once you have the pixels set, you click create new design and you will get the Canva white box. So it's just a blank box with a white background, and this is where you pretty much go to work. Now, the design we're working with, to remind you guys again, is this: I Still Live With My Parents. Nevertheless, once you're here on Canva, you want to find some text you can actually use for this design. Very easy to do. On the side tabs over here, you'll see the option that says text. You click that and then you'll be hit up with a lot of different options. I mean, you could be creative. The design we saw was black, so we will be going with black text. Right, I'll go with something like this because I think we can do something nice with this. Now, once you click on the text that we want to use, you just want to click on this little arrow. So pick a corner and then drag it out. and this will allow it to make it bigger. And as you can see, there's different variants of fonts there, and they're kind of all grouped together. So once you have it at the size that seems okay to yourself, you then want to click on ungroup. And as you'll be able to see, it's been split up into three sections. So you have the top part, the middle part, and the bottom part. Now I want to keep the boldest looking part of the font. So this part that says Cap'n Robbie, that's what we want. The rest, we don't really need that. So just quickly remove that by clicking delete. So I'll click delete, and then once that's gone, we can now get to work with this. So I'm gonna make it a bit smaller, and then I will drag it somewhere to the middle here, and then we're gonna change this so it says I still live with my parents. Nice and simple. It's not a complicated design. It's very, very simple. It stands out, kind of cute. I would recommend for you guys to drag it closer to the top of the screen, mainly because that puts it more in the chest area in terms of t-shirts. So drag it up a little bit, just like so. I mean, that should be okay here. But yeah, once your design is positioned, you then want to download it. Now for anyone using the free version, you won't be able to download this with a transparent background, which we'll go on to see. So I'll quickly click on the download button. Once I click on the download button, you see PNG is suggested. On the pro version, which I'm on at the moment, which you guys can actually get on with the free trial, or after the free trial, you can actually just select transparent background and download. But I understand a lot of you guys watching this video won't be on the pro version, so you won't have a transparent background. So I'm going to show you what to do with the colored background, how to resize, and pretty much all the good stuff. So I'll quickly download this as it is to start off with. So it says preparing your design, and then it's gonna go and download it. Right, the design is now downloaded. You guys can see it right there in the middle of the screen. I've now opened it as a picture on my PC. Yes, it's got a white background. When it comes to uploading on print on demand websites, you never want to have a white background, mainly because even on a white shirt, the whites would be different. And unless the background is needed in the design, I definitely always recommend using transparent backgrounds. Okay, step one, we want to remove the background. So you might be thinking, Phil, how do I remove the background? Just tell me already. Well, there's two ways. As you can see on the screen, we have Remove BG, which is the website that allows you to remove your background. And there's also photopea.com. Now, Remove BG is probably the easiest option, mainly because you can just upload your image and it will just remove the background straight away. But the downside of using this website is it only gives you one free credit to get a HD image. All the other images you download won't be in the highest quality they can be on. However, with Photopea, it's pretty much a free alternative of Photoshop, and using the magic tool, you can just remove the white background and still have an image that has good quality on it. Starting off with Remove BG, once you're here, you just want to make sure that you upload the image that you want them to remove the background on. Once you click upload on the image, they will instantly show you what it looks like with the background removed, as you guys can see there. Now, if I want to download in HD, as you can see, and I click that, it will say one credit. And to be able to get that one credit, I have to sign up for a free account. Now you can do that and get your one high quality image. But once again, a lot of people that do print on demand need more than just one credit. So what I would recommend for you guys to do, if you're thinking of using this option, is just clicking on this version, which is a bit lower in terms of quality, but I'll show you how you can boost it back up. So you just quickly download this. Now, step two, this is where it gets interesting. You want to be able to then resize your image. When I downloaded it, it downloaded it at 500 by 500 pixels. I will tell you right now, that is too small. When it comes to print on demand, I usually recommend 5,000 by 7,100 pixels on Redbubble, but if you want to cover all platforms, including merch by Amazon, then you can go with 4,500 by 5,400 pixels, which is what we're gonna be resizing our image to. Now, the website we'll be using is Bulk Resize. And once you're here, all you want to do is upload the image that you downloaded. So the image with the transparent background that you downloaded from the background removal website. Once you've selected your image and it's uploaded, this is the screen that you see right here. The first thing you want to do, you want to come onto this section where it says scale images to, change it from 50% to 100%. Image format, you want this at PNG, as that's the best quality. It says transparent background, check, make sure that's checked. Image dimensions, this is the juicy part here. So you want to change this from 800 pixels to 4,500 and then times 5,400. Now, once again, I'm using these dimensions mainly because these dimensions work with merch by Amazon as well. And I understand some of you guys that watch my videos use that, so I'm making sure that I've got your back too. Nevertheless, once you have this, you then want to just click start. And when you click start, it will start doing its magic, processing everything, and you'll see it will say completed. As soon as it says completed, it will download it straight away. But yeah guys, this right here is the image, transparent background. It's been resized to 4,500 by 5,400 pixels. That is the first method of using the transparent background website and then the resized website. However, if we were to jump onto photopea.com, once again, which is completely free to use, all you'd want to do is click on new project. Once you click new project, straight away, you can set your width and height to 4,500 by 5,400. Once this is done, you can change the DPI and put it higher to either 150 or 300. But as I'm showing you a quick example, I'm just gonna leave it the same for now. But yes, once you have your dimensions, you click create. The canvas will pop up just like this. And let's say if you downloaded your image from Canva with a white background, you then drag it onto here or you'd import it in. See, I'm just quickly dragging it on. So it's currently loading. You should be able to see it in a quick second. Boom, just like that, it's been dragged on. Hide the background layer there. And then you can see that this is the initial image that we would have downloaded from Canva. And as you can see, it's got a white background and we don't want that there. Fastest way of removing this is to go over to the side tab here. You want to make sure that you're clicking on the right layer and then you want to find the magic tool. So if you go 1, 2, 3, 4 tools down, you see the option that will allow you to select the magic wand. Once you click that, you can then come over the white area on the image, click that, and then it should highlight that. Right, but before you just try to remove the background, you need to make sure you rasterize the layer as well. So yeah, quickly rasterize that. So yeah, once the layer has been rasterized, you should then be able to just delete the white background fairly simply. Just like that, you can see the white background goes, and then you can zoom in a little further to make sure you catch the gaps between the letters. So yeah, it's easy to do that. You just go through clicking the different gaps. I'll show you an example with one, and then I'll just cut to when I've, you know, cut off all of the white spots. And then once you're done, this is now your image. As you can see, it looks very clear in comparison to the last method, and it was also very, very easy to do. At this point, you'd pretty much save it, export as PNG, and it will be saved with the file size and the dimensions that you set at the start. As you can see there, 4,500 by 5,400. You click save and then it downloads that, and you can now upload that image onto whatever print on demand site you need to use it on. That is it for the tutorial. I just wanted to do a quick one for you guys, showing you how to make best selling designs using Canva. Once again, if you want to use the pro version of Canva that actually allows you to download images with transparent background, you can try it out with a free 30-day trial that's linked down in the description. For anyone who has made it to the end of the video, down in the comment section, comment down Canva art. I will try to respond to as many people as I can. Always remember that everything is rigged in your favor, and manifest success.